Welcome. Today we will study Thevenin's theorem, which is to be used to solve circuit related problems. So in this theorem we have to study how to minimize a complicated circuit, and that is to be replaced by a voltage and in series with its internal resistance. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to apply Thevenin's theorem to find unknown voltage or current. Before starting with Thevenin's theorem, you should recall Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, series and parallel combination of passive circuit elements, voltage division, current division, star and delta connections, and source transformation. Now we'll see introduction to Thevenin's theorem. Thevenin's theorem is the most extensively used network theorem. So without going through the rigorous method of solving a set of network equations, we can determine the current through or voltage across any one element in network. So basically, if we want to minimize rigorous method to solve set of network equations or to minimize mathematical calculations in a network, we have to use Thevenin's theorem. Now see statement of Thevenin's theorem: any two terminal bilateral linear DC circuit can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of voltage source and a series resistor. So bilateral circuit element means current can flow from any terminal of the circuit element, and linear indicates that graph is linear, means as the value on x-axis will go on increase, so value on y-axis will also go on increasing. So that is linear. So generally Thevenin's theorem is to be applied to DC circuits. Now we'll see an example in which we have to apply Thevenin's theorem. So consider a simple DC circuit, which is to be shown in the figure, and the problem statement is: here we have to find out current IL flowing through the load resistor, and for that we have to use Thevenin's theorem. So in this diagram you can see that VS is source voltage, and three resistances are there: resistor R1, resistance R2, and resistance R3. And across this source network, load resistor RL is to be connected. The first step is we have to find equivalent voltage source, and for this we have to remove RL, that is load resistor, and across those terminal we have to find out open circuit voltage, which is to be represented by VOC, that is voltage across open circuit terminals or open circuit voltage. So here we can see that VS is the source voltage, current is I, three resistances are there: resistance R1, resistance R2, and resistance R3. As we remove load resistance, one terminal of the resistance R2 is connected in the circuit, but remaining or another terminal of resistance R2 is floating. So resistance R2 is dead. So VOC, open circuit voltage, will come across resistance R3. So formula for open circuit voltage VOC is VOC is equal to I into R3. Means voltage is equal to current multiplied by resistance. So VOC is I into R3, and current I is to be represented by voltage upon resistance. So current I in this case is source voltage VS upon addition of the resistances, that is resistance R1 and resistance R3, because these two resistances are in series. So like this we have got open circuit voltage VOC. Now we have to find out internal resistance, that is RTH, or that can be also called as a Thevenin's resistance, which is to be connected in series with VOC, open circuit voltage. And to find out RTH, we have to deactivate independent sources which are present in the circuit. And if that independent source is voltage source, we have to replace that voltage source by its internal resistance. Means we have to short circuit the branch. And if it is current source, we have to delete that current source, or we have to open circuit the terminals between which the current source is connected. So in our diagram or in our problem statement, voltage source is there, so we have to short circuit the branch, and looking from the terminals where load resistor is connected, we have to find out RTH. So RTH in this particular problem statement is resistance R2 in series with parallel combination of resistance R1 and resistance R3. So value of RTH in this case is R2 plus R1 into R3 upon R1 plus R3. So like this we can find out RTH, Thevenin's resistance. Now next step is we have to draw equivalent circuit for Thevenin's theorem, and across that again we have to connect load resistor RL. So here the source voltage is now VOC, open circuit voltage, in series with its internal resistance RTH, that is Thevenin's resistance, and across this we have to connect load resistor RL. Now here we can easily find out current IL flowing through the load resistor RL by using formula IL, that is load current, is equal to voltage upon total resistance. So voltage is VOC, that is open circuit voltage, upon resistance is RTH plus RL. We have to add these resistors because RTH, that is internal resistance or Thevenin's resistance, is connected in series with load resistor RL. So like this, the complicated network in which source voltage and three resistances are used, and that is to be replaced by a single voltage, that is VOC, and its internal resistance or Thevenin's resistance RTH. And now we can easily find out load current IL. While preparing this video lecture, I have referred circuit theory, analysis and synthesis by Chakrabarty, 6th revised edition. Thank you.